kill me first. If I die, she dies.
And the blood will be on your hands.
I suppose it all comes down to survival. Kill or be killed. This was it. This was my destiny. I had no choice.
He could have saved her without killing him.
How? You heard him. No choice.
But we always have a choice.
We seemingly have a choice, but it's all up to God.
Not that again. Even the fall of mankind?
For sure. God had the fall in mind so he could save us.
Have you ever seen this? College students argue theological points from a movie to rationalize their spirituality in a secular world. That's why we have brought in a specialist, Jacob Parmalee, to discuss theological truths to agree with his own tradition. Jacob?
Thank you, Jane. It's good to be here.
So what can you tell us about this argument?
First of all, the second student's argument was totally Beza. This deterministic view is way too limited. Grace is unlimited. The fall was a choice to disobey God.
So since grace is unlimited, we just have to accept it.
Not at all. See, prevenient grace is placed before us to activate our free will, but we have the choice to reject it.
So, it's our choice and God doesn't do anything?
Yeah, that's too black and white. By His grace, we can use our God-given intellect to choose what's right and wrong. Personal choice, such as salvation, is a gift from God. But once we activate that salvation, we can become perfect.
So you're perfect now?
No, not at all. But I'm headed on that path that's mapped out by Christ. And eventually, hopefully, I'll get there.
Well, it's time to wrap up now. Is there anything you can say to our audience about today's conversation, about life, any advice?
I guess don't worry too much about the little things. The first and most important thing is to share the love and life of Christ. A person's personal salvation comes first, then talk about choice and whether a believer can be made perfect. Movies can bring people to spiritual places, but don't let that be a divisive factor.
Thank you, Jacob, for being with us today. Tomorrow, please join us for the expert's exhilarating eschatological explanation. Good day.
So, do you really believe that?
Yeah! Why are you wrestling me?
I'm temporal choice versus eternal destiny, fool!
Yeah.